So, John, any viewer of WMUR knows that last fall there were a lot of these outside groups advertising, particularly in our governor's race, but you found that New Hampshire was almost an anomaly in the rest of the country.
Yeah, New Hampshire was, believe it or not, number one. Congratulations as far as outside spending was concerned. More money was spent per person by outside spending groups, and by that we primarily mean super PACs and nonprofits, non-candidate groups, than per person than in any other state in the country. And also, more money was spent by these outside special influence groups than was raised by the candidates themselves. And that was also a first. We didn't see that in any other state out of the 38 states that we looked at.
Yeah, yeah. According to your study, about $24 per vote were spent by these outside groups. You know, the New Hampshire governor only gets elected to 2 years of service. Why do you think there was such a big focus from these outside national groups up here in New Hampshire?
Well, you had an open seat, an open governor seat, which is relatively rare, although not so much in New Hampshire because you do have it's only a two-year term, which, by the way, you get to enjoy this all over again in 2015, or 2014, I'm sorry. The open seat makes a big difference, but so does the right to work, so-called right to work legislation. Unions don't like to hear it called that. That fires up the public sector unions. So they, after losing the recall effort in Wisconsin, they were motivated to get Democrats in governor's mansions to fight that legislation, and that had been an issue in New Hampshire, and I think that we saw that in much of the country where that seemed to really motivate a lot of spending, where you sort of had this classic, you know, clash of the titans between the unions and the business groups, and business groups won in some states and the unions won in other states.
And then, of course, there is our presidential primary. I believe the Democratic Governors Association said they spent $8 million, more than they've spent on any race in the history of the organization on the New Hampshire race for governor. Of course, the head of that last time was Martin O'Malley, the Maryland governor, who was just in New Hampshire last weekend, possibly looking at a presidential run. Are you going to see the same kind of outside spending in the race in, say, in Iowa as well?
I'm sorry, a theme in outside spending in races?
Because of our presidential primary, you think that's one of the reasons why, particularly
of
these ambitious folks are spending so much money?
Yeah, I don't think there's any question that the early primary states, caucus states, get a lot of attention from outside groups. Because of the presidential primaries and caucuses, you've got national players that are on the ground there early and often. You want to have a friendly governor there. It's key. I mean, We tend to think of governments as in tiers, you know, state, local, and federal. When really, when it comes to the party, you know, they're all sort of in the same in it together. So I don't think it's by coincidence that New Hampshire was the focus of so much money, particularly from outside groups. Outside groups, which by the way were both of the two biggest groups based in Washington, and you wouldn't have known who they were by the names that they went by and how they were spending the money in New Hampshire, which is a major problem for these organizations.
And if I'm just an average voter, kind of casually watching this conversation, what difference does it make if an outside group is buying an ad, you know, attacking a Republican or attacking a Democrat, or if it was a candidate's money attacking a Republican or attacking a Democrat?
I think it's the considering the source of the message. It's almost impossible to do that, at least casually. If you want to do a little bit of research, you can. I mean, in New Hampshire, we had, you know, two groups that spent the most money. We had the Live Free PAC, which sounds wonderful, and the New Hampshire Freedom Fund. And unless you were at least somewhat sophisticated, you wouldn't know that one was a front group for the Democratic Governors Association, which is an unincorporated nonprofit with offices right down the street here in Washington, and the other one was a Republican Governors Association front group, also with offices right down the street here in Washington. The Democratic group was primarily funded by unions. The Republican group is funded by billionaires and corporations. These are the guys who are paying for that message, who's bashing a local candidate, and you would not know that. You would maybe you're taken on faith. Maybe you watch a political ad and you actually believe what they say. as opposed to, you know, are skeptical because of who the source of the ad was.
Right.
I think the thing that really concerns us at the state level is that there is so much money that's coming in, it dwarfs local money, and it's almost a question of, you know, who's pulling the strings in your state. Is it local people, or is it outside groups that have their own special interests?
Lastly, I want to ask you, your report seems to draw a direct line between the Citizens United Supreme Court decision and the growth of all this outside money in New Hampshire, maybe around the country. Do you think that in the next election cycle, in 2014, for example, that the outside money will continue to dwarf what is our own candidates are spending?
Yeah, 2014, we're going to see an all-time explosion in outside money at the state races. For one thing, there's 36 governor's races, I believe 36, there may even be more, that are up for grabs. The 2010 Citizens United decision, were just, you know, the groups were just starting to get good at it in 2010, the last time we had that many governor's races. I mean, they were just starting to get used to it. In 2014, they will have it mastered. In terms of, you know, the groups will be more mature, they will have a sense of how to spend the money, they will also have had more time gathering up the donors to create these fundraising networks. So, you know, we're expecting an absolute explosion in outside spending in the states. And, you know, one thing to add to that is that the Citizens United decision didn't affect all states. A lot of states were sort of wild west as it was, like Virginia here, we just had a primary where there's unlimited corporate and union contributions are legal to candidates. You know, there are restrictions in other states. So the Citizens United decision actually affected only 24 out of the 50 states. One of them that it did affect very directly was New Hampshire.
John, thanks so much for joining us.
It's my pleasure.